season has come to an end. And welcome everybody to the channel. My name is Big Boy Variety. You already know who I am. If you've subscribed here before, you've come and seen these videos before, come on down, leave a like, share, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell, do all that good stuff. If you hear something in the background, that's not me, it's something else going on in the background. If you hear a train or something, it's okay. NFL, week 17. The game, last game of the season, game 256. It is over. We might as well get this out the way first. The butt-covery cost the Cowboys a playoff spot. That combined with whatever the Philadelphia Eagles were thinking against the Washington football team. Because they took out Jalen Hurts. He was doing fine. He was doing well. They had two touchdowns, lead the team down the field against the football team. And yet they took him out for Nate Sudfeld. Carson Wentz wasn't even dressed. I mean, this game was awful. This Washington-Philadelphia game was just god-awful. What a terrible game it was. And I'm just glad it's over. But what we do have is the football team at 7-9 has won the division, the NFC East. Tank division is yours, Washington. And I'm just going to be mad for weeks about, you know, losing on a butt fumble by Wayne Gallman. Because we had this game on the wraps. There wasn't even a challenge that should have been called by Mike McCarthy, but it just didn't happen. It didn't happen against the Giants either. But I don't know. I'm just glad the season's over. Giants and Cowboys are going to get a high draft pick. Eagles are also going to get a high draft pick for sure. Cowboys need some help on that defense. Giants need some help everywhere. You know, Eagles need help everywhere. So, tank division, the three of us are going to go sleep. You know, the Cowboys, the Eagles, and the Giants. They're going to go sleep until it's time to find some time to get some quality players on the field. As far as some other games that didn't matter go, the Bucks, they clinched the 5 seed pretty easy against the Falcons. Nothing really to worry about there. Jets lost to the Patriots. Adam Gase, he's gone. He is fired. It's over for him. So the Jets will have to look for somebody new. There's many names that you can throw in a hat that you can find for the job, and I don't know who's going to take this job. It's going to be hard to take this job. Patriots finished 7-9. Terrible season for them. You'd think that they'd be going back to the playoffs this year, you know, especially under Bill Belichick's system, but that did not happen. Cam Newton is probably gone as well, so there you go. That experiment is over. Vikings, they beat the Lions on their last game of the season. They finished 7-9. Pretty disappointing for them. It's always a disappointment for the Lions, you know. Another bad season in the books for the Lions. Now we wouldn't know this until later on in the day, but the Dolphins were eliminated from playoff contention, you know, after, you know, they got beat by the Bills. We're talking bad. You know, Isaiah McKenzie got 3 touchdowns on the Dolphins. Dolphins couldn't do a damn thing. And no Ryan Fitzpatrick. Tua was in the game, and then I think they put somebody else in afterwards for like a possession or something like that, and then Tua came back in. But it didn't matter, because Josh Allen, Stephon Diggs and company just took them to the slaughterhouse. Beat them up real bad. And it was rough, you know. I think they should have kept with Fitz, but, you know, like I said, all the way back when Tua was revealed to be the starter, I think they should have kept with Fitzpatrick, but you know what? It is what it is. It is what it is. So the Browns locked up a playoff spot by beating the Steelers. They will go to Pittsburgh next week, so I'm going to see these two teams 2 weeks in a row. I didn't see this game today on purpose. I chose to watch the Dolphins-Bills game instead, and then I flipped to the Steelers-Browns. So, you know, it is what it is. Ravens, I knew they were going to lock up a playoff spot. So that's why I didn't really focus on them beating up on the Bengals like this. They beat them up bad, 38-3. Real rough. Real rough. Colts, they don't get to win the division, but they do get to go to the playoffs by virtue of the Dolphins losing, and they beat the Jags. You know, it would have been kind of hilarious to see that the Jags beat the Colts, you know, twice for their only two victories of the season, but instead, 15 straight losses for the Jags, and they could be drafting Trevor Lawrence at number one now. It's probably going to happen, but it remains to be seen. We'll find that out in April, of course. The Titans, they had the doink in a field goal to beat the Texans. And guess what? Derrick Henry, 2,000-yard club. Congrats, my dude. Congrats. You have absolutely earned being a 2,000-yard rusher. Just been dominant in this league the past 2 years. Been damn good these past 2 years. So what about, you know, the battle of two quarterbacks? You know, I've already forgotten this man's name who was playing for the Cardinals with Kyler Murray and got injured, like Slidervire or whatever his name was. I didn't forgot his name already. And John Wolford of the AAF, the Arizona Hotshots. And the Rams came out and won this game. You know, Kyler did come back into the game late, but it was too late. We're talking the Rams defense stepped up again at the right time. I don't think they got an offensive touchdown in this game. They stepped up at the right time. The Rams did. Got a safety. Got a bunch of interceptions. Got a lot of stuff to go well. And the Rams clinch a playoff spot in the Cardinals, man. You gotta be shaking your heads right now. You guys blew it. You guys blew it. Blew a chance at the playoffs. These last 2 weeks, you should have beaten San Francisco last week, and you would have been in. You probably would be in right now, but no, that did not happen. You gave us one of the best games of the season with that game with the Bills, and you blew it. Unbelievable. This might be a worse choke job than the Raiders. Absolutely insane. Absolutely crazy. Speaking of another game, it doesn't really matter because the Packers locked up the number one seed. You know, they beat up on the Bears. The Bears, thanks to the Cardinals losing, they go to the playoffs. So, yeah. Bears looked rough in that game, and the Packers just walked all over them. I mean, Aaron Rodgers has 48 touchdowns. This man is winning the MVP. Devontae Adams has 18 catching. Aaron Jones is doing damn good. Even though they lost Bakhtiari, you know, that defense has been playing pretty great, you know, for the Packers these past few weeks. And the Saints, they slide on down to the number two spot. But they beat up on the Panthers. That's a good sign. And the Saints are looking like a damn good contender in the NFC. Definitely watch out for them. There are some other games that do not matter, actually. And I'm very surprised to see that the Chargers beat the Chiefs. But, I mean, the Chiefs, I think they started Chad Henne in that game. So doesn't really matter for the Chiefs. They get a first round bye. Mahomes wasn't going to play. You know, and the Chargers end their season on a good note. They just got to find a way to stop choking away games, and they'd be in the playoffs. They'd be in the playoff discussion and things like that right now, you know, if they didn't choke this season away. Bigger choke artists than Atlanta. But, you know, Justin Herbert, man, that guy can play ball. He's got weapons around him. I'm thinking next year, the Chargers, they'll need a good draft too. But I'm thinking, you know, they'll have to re-sign some guys and get some good pieces, stuff like that. But I'm thinking the Chargers could go to the playoffs in the 2021 season. I'm thinking that. Now, don't quote me on that, but I'm thinking Chargers could be damn good next year. Seahawks, they had some trouble with the 49ers, who pretty much eliminated the Cardinals last week. Seahawks, they got the W. They get to host the playoff game. Sadly, they'll be number three. Seahawks have been kind of inconsistent all season long, to be completely honest with you. They'll have great games, and then they'll have games like this, you know, to where it's just, ugh, gross. But the Seahawks, you know, they got this W, they got it done. And, you know, things are going to be good. So now, last but not least, Raiders, Broncos. There was a big catch by Jerry Jeudy, but inevitably, the Raiders did, in fact, win that game against the Broncos by 1 point. Raiders got to fix some things in the offseason, too. Defense. Broncos, they definitely have to fix some things. I think it's on defense, but I mean, the Broncos are just such a weird team to where it's like, they're kind of okay. They don't really stand out to me, and that's why I don't watch a lot of their games. So they're just kind of there. That's what they are. They're just kind of there, and they can give you a fight any time of the week. But I think Drew Locke, you know, he'll have something to build around for next year, because he's got guys. Jerry Jeudy, got guys. KJ Hamler, got guys. You know, those guys can run, you know. You know, they still got Melvin Gordon, I think, in the backfield. But again, things are definitely going to need to change. Again, you know, for some of these other teams that didn't make it, Panthers, I think it's just going to take a while. It's going to take a while for the Panthers, but they were in a bunch of fights this year with some damn good teams, you know, and they played their hearts out for most of these games. So I think the Panthers, they'll be fine. I think it'll be another rebuilding year for Matt Rhule. You know, same thing he did at Temple. I think it'll take some time. They just gotta give Matt Rhule the time in Carolina. They gotta give him the time to, you know, get things together. As far as the Texans go, oh, this is gonna be rough. You know, you lost the draft pick, you lost your best wide receiver. You could lose Deshaun Watson, maybe, potentially, I don't know, if he decides to go anywhere or something like that, or unless he's sticking around. But Texans just need everything on defense. They need a lot of things on defense. They need an offensive line. They I don't want to see Deshaun Watson, you know, end up on the ground with a broken leg, something like that, because he didn't have an offensive line. Just absolutely disgusting by the Texans. I was expecting better from this team this year. Expecting a whole lot better. Cardinals, same thing. I was expecting a whole lot better from this team this year. And that didn't happen. That did not happen. You know, I was thinking air raid. Oh, yeah, I like the air raid. Air raid is exciting, you know. You know, it's the same, like, 5 to 6 plays. You can run it out of 10 different formations, you know, and things would be booming. But it was not booming. Cliff Kingsbury, you know, they just do not have the play call. It's really the play calling sometimes for the Cardinals. They just got to get some better plays in. They got to get something going. When they don't have a spark, when the air raid is not working, when you're passing 50 to 60 times a game, or when you have Kyler Murray running the ball 10-20 times a game, it's just not working. Something's got to give. You got to find something. You got to find a balance. Jags, it was just rough for the Jags this year, I'm not going to lie to you. Again, they might get Trevor, I don't know, but it was just rough. I think it'll be another rough year for them next year. Bengals, I think they're going to need some time to rebuild. They have Joe Burrow. They have Joey Burrow. And it's sad to see that he got injured at the end of this year. But, you know, Bengals, they have a solid guy there. But I think, you know, things are going to need to change, you know, on defense as well. And definitely an offensive line, too. They need an offensive line to protect Joe Burrow. Like I said about the Cowboys, going to need an offensive line. You know, same thing, need an offensive line, need a defense. Giants need... They need Jason Garrett to call better plays, honestly. You know, there were some plays that worked in this game, you know, against the Cowboys, but some plays that were just god-awful. Same thing with the Cowboys. Bad play calling at times, you know, questionable decisions to go with, you know, everything. I mean, it was just a tumultuous season as a fan of this team. Just rough. Dolphins, I think they need to give Tua a little bit more time. I don't think he shouldn't have started this year. I don't think he should have. But, you know, it is what it is. Jets just need to blow everything up. They need to blow everything up. Falcons, they have contract issues. They have guys like Julio and Matt Ryan that have contract issues. They just need to do something about those and not choke away games. They have the talent there. It's just, have you choked this away so many times? They've choked away like 5 or 6 different games this year. They could have been in the playoffs. It's baffling. The Vikings and the Lions, I think they're both kind of the same story, to where they have a quarterback that's pretty good, but everything else around them is just pretty mediocre. Like they have guys that can produce on offense, definitely, you know, like Thielen for the Vikings or Galladay for the Lions. But everything else is just like, what is going on out here? What is this nonsense? Defense, rough, you know, giving up bad plays at inopportune times. The offensive lines not doing what they need to do, you know. Just rough times for both of these teams. So, we have 14 that made it this time instead of 12, and this will be the future of the NFL, you know, for now. We have 14 teams that made it. Colts Bills on next Saturday to start the super wild card round. Colts Bills next Saturday, then the Rams and the Seahawks, and then the Bucks and the football team. And then on Sunday, Ravens, Titans, Bears, and the Saints get to settle down. You get that Nickelodeon slime on you. I wonder how that's going to go, honestly, the Nickelodeon thing with the Bears and the Saints. And then the Browns, Steelers, part 3. Because I already saw the first 2 parts. Boy, but those were some good games. Well, the first one was terrible. The second one was pretty good. But Browns, Steelers, part 3 should deliver. Rams, Seahawks should deliver. Ravens, Titans, oh boy. Derrick Henry could be, you know, it's going to be looking like that matchup last year if Derrick Henry goes off. Bucks, Washington, I think there might be a blowout, but I don't know. Same thing with Bears, Saints, I think there might be a blowout, but I don't know. We'll see what happens there. Colts, Bills is a toss-up to me. So, but I'll talk about all those in a few days. So, with that being said, everybody, we made it. 256 games, 17 weeks, 2020 season is pretty much over. And now, 4 weeks of playoffs left to go. And then this season is done. I'm gonna miss it. So, like, share, comment, subscribe, do all the good stuff. Click the notification bell like I already said at the beginning of the video. And yada, yada, yada. And I'll see you